Well, as you know, all month long, we've been celebrating Tom Skilling as he gets ready to retire from WGN.
In this throwback Ask Tom, he responds to a viewer's question about ball lightning.
I'd never seen anything like that before in my life.
It happened here on William Street in Aurora at about 1 a.m. on Monday morning, Labor Day. The day before had been hot, over 90 degrees, and the atmosphere was unstable and ready to blow. Mike's baby had been awakened by a thunderstorm so active that he likened it to cannon shots in a war zone. Standing inside his front screen door and looking out at the wild display of lightning outside, he wasn't prepared for what he was about to see.
It looked to me like someone walking down the center of the street with a flashlight, and I couldn't figure out what they were doing, so I kind of stuck my head out, and there was nobody there. It was just this orange light drifting down the street, maybe twice as fast as a person walks.
What Mike had seen is one of the rarest weather phenomena, ball lightning, also known as globe lightning. For years, it was the subject of controversy in the meteorological community. Did such a thing, it was asked, really exist?
It got right over here to the intersection and just kind of went poof.
A lightning storm, like this one, may produce ball lightning, the existence of which few now refute. Here's what's commonly reported with ball lightning. It usually appears as a luminous ball, reddish in color, basketball-sized, about a foot in diameter. It moves along solid objects or, as in Mike's case, floats in midair, emitting a hissing noise. I've even heard of it floating through a front door and through a living room as people sat watching television and then out an open window. It can leave an electrical burning smell and may disappear noiselessly or sometimes explode.
It was very exciting. I said, we got to tell somebody, Mike. Mm-hmm. There's someone who would be interested in knowing this. You know, I said, I bet Tom Skilling would be interested in this.
That's great.
You're right.